Mommy, what was that noise? Mommy,
what is it, sweetie?
I said, what was that noise?
Nothing, sweetie. I just ran over a big frog.
No, you didn't, Mommy. Frogs don't sound like that. Mommy, I'm bored. I want to open my eyes.
Please, just be a good girl and keep your eyes closed like I told you. Okay, sweetie?
Mommy!
Oh, sweetie.
so sorry.
Oh, you're okay. It's okay.
Alright. Hello. Sorry for the long delay, but here we are. I got that a little more silent. Okay, so this is the first episode of this Dead Rising series. I have played this game many times before, and well, I'm willing to make it my first game for this stream. Let me refresh the chat real quick. Alright. Everything seems to be fine. And we should be okay. So I'm gonna be starting this on level 50 because I do want to showcase the story more than the grinding aspect of it. And I think that's what mostly stands out from that from this game. So, without further ado, let's start this journey.
Buddy, you mentioned something about research for a story.
That's right. Got a tip that something big's happening.
In a nowhere little town like that? They sure didn't mention anything about it on TV.
Yeah, well, I'm freelance, pal. I don't make my living waiting for the TV to tell me what to cover.
She is. Willamette, Colorado. Population 53,594. Distinguishing characteristics? Jack shit. About the only thing to do in this town is kill time at the shopping mall. What was that? The army?
Looks like taking a helicopter was the way to go. I bet they got all the roads blocked off by now. All right, listen. I want to get shots of the whole town before the National Guard finishes roping it off. Take me over the main street.
All right. So this is the start of the game. I remember these controls because I have not played it for a while. You may notice my graphics seem a little bit lowered.
What is that? Some kind of riot?
It was just a necessity that I needed for streaming and just playing the game altogether. In other words, I need a stronger PC. Since we are starting at level... Since we are starting at level 50, there's no need for me to take any pictures, but for exposition purposes, we'll just pretend we're gaining PP.
Business as usual in this town.
You are able to skip this once you beat the game. However, it does skip an important cutscene, so this is why I'm going through it. Frame rate went down there for a second.
Take us down. We have to check out that building.
Where?
Right below us.
Oh crap. I missed the picture. Damn. Oh well.
I want to see the center of town. Take me there.
Roger.
There you go.
Top of that mall?
You gotta be kidding me. Man, you are nuts.
Alright, listen. Don't forget to come back for me.
As long as you're not dead, Fred.
It's Frank. Frank West. Remember that name, because the whole world's gonna know it in 3 days when I get the scoop.
Reporter, aren't you?
Yeah.
You came alone?
Yeah, I'm freelance. You know, going to the battlefield alone, no crew. So, what's going on around here anyway?
You came by helicopter, didn't you? What did you see from the sky?
Well, if it were just a riot, I doubt the military would quarantine the entire area. The moratorium on information getting out is a little extreme, in my opinion. There's, something else I can't put my finger on. Doesn't sound like civil disobedience. It's too quiet.
Almost as if everyone's already dead.
Yeah. So why don't you just tell me already? What's going on?
I think you'd better see for yourself. This, my friend, is hell.
Alrighty. Time. Frank must be on the heliport at 12 p.m. on the 22nd, or he will be left behind in the mall. Pay careful attention to the time as you play. Okay, so finally have control of Frank. Wait. Okay, you can't do anything on the rooftop, or anything for that matter. Looks like you're the only journalist that made it out of here. I'm looking forward to some nice pictures. Okay, he just repeats the same thing. Saving. You can save your progress at locations marked with S, such as the sofa in the security room or the mall's public restrooms. It's going to become very, very useful information. And for those who don't know, there's a pee-pee sticker right here.
Fantastic!
There you go. First save. I gotta check if it's the same slot. Yeah. Right here. I am going to stick with the original outfit for now. However, unless told otherwise, you know, I can always wear another outfit. There doesn't seem to be any food at the moment. What about my unlock weapons? Yeah, here they are. Rules for these two weapons for myself. For the Mega Buster, no using it on bosses, and only zombies. Same with the Light Sword. No bosses, only zombies. And I might make it a rule to wear, like, this is the only copy of the weapon I'll use, and then the rest is going to be like a vanilla run. But let's check it out.
No time to ogle pretty girls, son. You looking to get yourself beaten alive by zombies?
What? Did you just say zombies?
Take a look out there. If those ain't zombies, what would you call them? There's been more and more of them since last night. Now, they're all that's out there. Eh, look on the bright side. Zombies are stupid and slow. We should be safe in here. All right, then. Feel like making yourself useful? Take a look around the mall. Bring anything we can use for the barricade back here. Andale! Come on, pronto!
All right. Items. Different items perform different actions. Excuse me. Some weapons are capable of special attacks performed by holding X for a moment. Multiple items can be held in stock simultaneously. The maximum stock number can be raised by leveling up.
Damn it! Every time I come shopping with you, something happens to raise my blood pressure.
What do you mean every time? You don't even come home most nights, let alone get out of shopping.
So? I work for a living.
Work?
Zombies are too slow.
Is that what you call that hanky-panky with that big-titted secretary now?
Oh, please. What the hell does that have to do with anything?
Listen to me. Every time something goes wrong, you have to raise your voice. I never should have married you.
You want to split up then? Sounds great. I can't wait to see the look on your face when those zombies eat you. It'll be hilarious.
That's my line, Buster.
Well, we'll see about that.
You! Stop right there! Do you have any idea what you've done? Why did you summon me to this place? What are you planning?
Would you calm down? I don't even know what you're talking about. What the?
God, that frame rate already concerns me. Alright. Here we go. Jesus. I just take everything with me. Oops. Wow, that frame rate is not... it's not gonna go well. Ah! Off. It's probably lagging a little more since I am streaming. Usually this game goes at a decent rate. Also, this analog stick is showing its age. So, I apologize for my sniffling in the middle, but I don't know. Something's up with my nose. But anyway, cutscene.
Where are the others?
I don't know. I hope they got away.
As long as those things are in the mall, we better not use this door.
What are you doing?
The air ducts. They'll get us back into the mall, and apparently those things aren't smart enough to use the ducts. So they won't be a factor.
Wait a minute. You want to get back in there? What for? Hey.
Nice camera. Are you a photographer?
As a matter of fact, I am. Frank West, photojournalist.
Could you show me some pictures, Frank?
You really seem to know what you're doing. Who are you guys, anyway? And what are you... I took that one near the entrance. That guy do something?
No. Thanks for showing me, though.
Hey, we're not done talking yet. Just who are you guys?
I'm Jesse. The man you saw earlier is Brad. That's all I'm authorized to tell you.
Keyword, authorized. Time until helicopter arrival. Wait, just give me a second. Okay. Alrighty then. Still have my weapons. Still have a snack. You ain't planning on going back down into the mall, are you? I wouldn't do that if I were you. Oops. If you're gonna go, at least take this transceiver with you. And you'd better take this... Okay. Those things are all over the mall. Be careful out there. What do I do? I gotta make sure. I do have the full Mega Man outfit from other playthroughs. So I can be styling. However, I mean, it's up to the audience. I'll just keep it like... excuse me. I'll keep it like that until, like, further notice. Alright.
thing.
I'm gonna activate the dialogue. Come on.
You can't be serious.
Looking for someone? I'll lend a hand. That'll be great, fellow. The name's Jeff Mayer, by the way. Mayer? I'm Frank. I'm a journalist. Alright. Even if I do have level 50, I'm also going to make an effort to get survivors back into the safe house. Because, I mean, why not? You know? We're going to have a lot of time to kill anyway. So, might as well. Escorting survivors. Survivors each behave differently depending on the circumstances and their own varying personalities. It is a good idea to escort as many as possible to the safety of the security room. The security room. My bad. I said safe room. I mean, safe house because of Dead Rising 2. So, you'll be able to call him in order room.
Come on! Come on!
Mister!
Oh, jeez. Wow, that actually landed back. Okay. It's too dangerous here. Oops. Jeff.
Fantastic.
Oh, Natalie. I'll never let you go again. Alright, you two. You mind cutting your joyous reunion short? It's not safe here, but I know a place. I'll take you to the security room. Follow me.
No way.
Come on. There we go. Okay, I was gonna speak. I'm never going to the mall again as long as I live. I've had about enough of this. Did I read that right? My mind went blank there for a second. But there you go. First two survivors. And we're gonna be hearing that for the rest of the game.
I really owe you one.
Nice. Alright. Alright, let's hurry into the mall. Okay, not yet. I do need a very important weapon. Hey, it's Otis. Back at the security room. Let me give you a rundown on the mall's layout so you know what you're doing. Right on the other side of the warehouse, you'll find Paradise Plaza. There's a lot of shops there. Restaurants, sporting goods, books, you name it. It's a pretty big mall, so you probably need to use the can now and then. So yeah, he's just basically telling us, you know, save often. For squash? Yes it is. Why not? Cabbage. Okay.
Zombies, huh? Had a feeling you'd show up. Up on
me. Brad was attacked. I located him on the monitor. Ugh.
It's probably just a sprain.
I've got to help Brad, or he's done for.
All right,
Fine. Give me your gun. Come on. I'm the reason you just got hurt. Let me help.
No, I can't let a civilian do that. That's against regulations.
Yeah, well, I don't think they had zombie-infested malls in mind when they wrote those regulations, kid.
You know how to use this?
Kinda. I've covered wars, you know. Look, after I'm through helping you, you and I are gonna have a nice little chat.
All right. Case 1-1. We have a bunch of cases ahead of us. Oh, there goes the 2x4. The case panels form a guide to solving the mystery behind the incident. When you encounter a key event, a new case panel opens, taking you one step closer to the truth. You can take a look at the current status of the case panels via the case file option on the pause menu. When all the case panels have been filled in, the truth behind the incident will be revealed. So now we got a handgun from her. Isn't that neat? Yeah, we got a bit of time to kill. Since we have time to kill, let's showcase some weapons. But first, I do have to get some very important magazines for later. I think it's this one? A book. The act of holding a book is enough to activate its properties. Different books have different effects. PP. PP gained from photography or defeating zombies is increased. Skill plus. Learn skateboarding or cycling tricks or valuable skills that can make the escorting of survivors easier. Some books have an effect on other items in your possession. Items affected by these books are marked with purple book. Heal plus. The restorative power of food consumption is boosted. Multiple books can be held in tandem to further increase the bonus percentage. Item plus. Items covered in the book's contents experience. Oh wait, I read that wrong. Items covered in a book's contents experience an appreciable increase to their durability. This effect can be augmented by holding multiple books with the same effect. I don't remember what this one was. No, that one's not it. This one? Entertainment related goods. Interior design? Hold on to interior design goods. I don't remember which one it was, actually. I think it has to be entertainment, but I'm not too sure. I'll have to hold on to it for now. I know another magazine or book is in, Wonderland Plaza. But first, we'll get to the case file, because that's the most important one. I can't even dodge for some reason. There we go. Frank, you there? It's me, Otis, the janitor. You said you're a journalist, right? I've been watching the monitors here, and I got some info. There's some young guy wandering around Paradise Plaza. He's carrying a camera like you. I guess he must be a photographer too, taking pictures at a time like this. You're both crazy. Scoop queue. The scoop queue provides a list of current requests along with relevant information on survivors. If you are able to fulfill the objectives laid out in the scoop queue before time runs out, you can receive PP or learn more about the incident. Wait. No more than 6 hours remain, less than 6 hours remain, less than 3 hours remain, and no time limit. By setting a guide arrow, you will be able to more easily navigate your way to a given goal. Guide arrows can be set via the watch screen, left D-pad, or the map screen, accessed via the pause menu. Guide arrow cursor, scoop details. Alright. Wow. I actually didn't know that was possible. Alright, here we go. Oh, crap. Still trying to be used to the controls. Escape commands. When grabbed by multiple zombies, an escape command will appear on the screen. Enter the commands as directed before the time runs out, and you can escape this dangerous situation. Alright, there we go. Nothing but a scratch.
Your girlfriend sent me to find you.
Who? Jesse? Damn it! Okay, we'll have to talk about this later. You know how to use that gun?
I've never fired at a person.
All right, I'll cover you from here. You need to stick to the shadows. Try to get close to the target, okay?
And what am I supposed to do when I get close?
Well, the best solution would be to shoot the guy. But if you can't do that, keep him busy dodging your bullets and stay out of trouble. Are you up to it?
I'm a lot better with a camera. But yeah, I'll give it a shot.
All right. Next time he reloads, I'll lay down a suppressing fire. I'm counting on you. Make your way over there. One, two, three!
Alright. Another secret is, these plates are actually, destructible. I can take the damage, since I am pretty leveled up. I just need one more. There we go. 10,000 PP for you. Okay, here we go. You may be wondering, why do I have a mannequin torso? Well, apparently this silly weapon is actually one of the strongest weapons in the game. Right next to the Mega Buster and the Laser Sword. So in a minute, you're gonna see its wrath in all of its glory. One, oh, crap. There you go. Two shots.
Got away. Who was that anyway?
I don't know. Well, thanks for your help. The name's Brad.
I'm Frank West, photojournalist. And right now, I'd rather have an explanation than thanks, Brad.
Sorry, I've got nothing to tell you. Look, I don't know what Jesse told you, but as far as I'm concerned, we're through working together. So you cover your zombie story, and leave the rest to us.
You guys are looking for someone here, aren't you?
Who is that? Where did you take
it? You help me, I help you.
Damn. You're one hell of a journalist, aren't you, Frank? A hot-headed, underhanded hotshot paparazzi with nothing better to do than to invade people's privacy.
I try. You got a point.
You win, Frank. Let's work together. Jesse and I are DHS agents. And yes, we are looking for the man in that picture.
You're with Homeland Security. Is that guy a terrorist or something? I took that picture in the entrance plaza. Right near the front door.
The entrance plaza. You're sure?
Hey! So do I have your permission to cover this story, or not?
Indeed. Indeed. Alright, case 1-2. On second thought, I'm gonna leave this here. I'll put some bullets out of this. I guess he's already shooting his brain away. Let's see. Another secret to keep in mind is there is a secret Uzi on top of this. Oops. We will be taking that. Okay, just kill my thunder. That's fine, sir. That's all, they didn't even have an arm.
Sir, if you could just kindly come with us, we can wrap this whole thing up.
No, I'm not leaving until you can
absolutely
guarantee
sir
me safe passage.
Just open this gate. Just open this gate,
no,
for your protection.
I am not opening any gate. Thank you very much. I'm going to stay right here.
Dr. Barnaby. Sir.
Thank you and goodbye.
Dr. Barnaby?
Well, what happened?
I think you know what happened, Frank.
You can't just arrest him?
He turned down my offer to protect him. Said he isn't going anywhere until I can guarantee a secure route out of here. Jesse has a direct line to HQ. The first thing we need to do is to call for backup.
Case 1-3. Frank, right now you're in the entrance plaza. Looks like you got the shutter open. If you want to change into some fresh... Okay. I know I can change my hair color here, I think. Is there a difference? No? No, I don't think there's a difference. There it is. There's the different hair color. But it's not my style. Alright. Let's get back to the, okay. I'm gonna go the other way. Wait a minute. Oh yeah, the other entrance is not open yet.
Ugh.
waste time. Frank, you're in the food court now. You might want to try mixing different foods in the blenders out there, if you're lucky.
Yeah.
I'm thinking of, doing the stream, like right after the cutscene. So... is that? This is just a... I mean, for the most part, this whole episode is kind of like a test, but it is also the introduction. You should get out of here. Somebody barricade a woman's clothing shop in Alfresca Plaza. From the looks of it, two people. Man, I'm not a fast reader, aren't I? Loading screen actually takes a while. Oh, watch this. Goes. Also, there's another hidden weapon. I don't know if it appears now or whenever it's not in my inventory, but oh crap. Alright, well, I made a wall jump on accident. Wait, why? Alright, there we go. I'll take the orange juice. Give me a second. Alright, my bed. Almost made that one. Yeah, there it is. Another Uzi. At your convenience. No! You'd think guns would be the most useful weapon in this game, but it's really not. Alright, cutscene.
So that's what Dr. Barnaby said, huh?
The old coot's not dumb. He wants us to call for help first. We gotta line out or what?
The signal's being blocked. I can't even contact HQ on the emergency line.
So, if we wanna get our hands on Dr. Barnaby, we're gonna have to secure a way out of here ourselves. Alright, we've gotta deal with the situation we've been handed. The boneheads back at HQ might be working on something too.
There's a helicopter coming. 3 days from now. At noon, it's my ride.
Is your ride reliable?
Absolutely. That's how I plan on getting out of here.
All right, then. I'll see to it that the DHS picks up the charter fee. Can we take Dr. Barnaby as well?
Sure. As long as you tell me what's going on.
Okay. I'll tell you what you want to know. Later. We have more pressing business right now. If we have to wait here for 3 days, we'll need supplies. Water, blankets and the like. We'll get Dr. Barnaby here tomorrow morning. I want you to keep an eye on the monitors.
Alright, case 1 to 4 complete. The next case will occur at 6 a.m. So first off, let's go ahead and save. Make sure. Save. And there you go. I will be stopping it right here, and hopefully another day I'll have the opportunity to stream, because I am pretty busy throughout the entire week, and hopefully that day comes sooner. So thank you to the ones who did watch. And if no one watched, then, you know, hopefully it gets viewed later on. You know, it's all about growth during streaming. So, thank you, and good night.